everyone. Last class we had some disturbances, but nonetheless, let us quickly review what we did in the previous class. We started off with analog to digital conversion, and in that we had seen that the analog signal can be converted into digital form by using successive approximation method. If you remember, in the successive approximation method, you had the similar comparator, op-amp as a comparator, and instead of a ramp generator, you had D2A converter. So what we, hopefully I'm audible and visible. So in the successive approximation method, we generated the clock pulse train, which was corresponding to my analog signal approximately. So if the analog signal was 8 volts, I would be generating the clock pulses which are equivalent to maybe 7.5 volts. And those pulse trains would give me, so this gate will be open only for clock pulses. This end will be closed. This port will be closed. So approximately 7.5 volt equivalent of digital signal I would be generating, and then it will show some digital signal corresponding to those pulse trains, and the same signal was converted into analog form by using D2A converter. And as you know, it was 7.5 volts. So original signal is 8 volts, and a generated signal by the clock is around 7.5 volts. So this successively I go on increasing, and then this gate will be opened, or this port will be opened, only when the generated voltage signal is approximately equal to my unknown analog signal. Okay, so the analog signal. So approximately equal to or greater than analog signal. So then the comparator compares that value, and this port will be electronically opened. So when this generated voltage becomes equal to my analog voltage, that indicated, the counter indicated the digital value. This is what was the principle of successive approximation type of ADC. Now ramp ADC, as I told in the last class, which we missed because of some network issues, ramp, the name ramp corresponds to a slope. Ramp means slope. As a mechanical engineer, you must have visited many of the service stations. Jitha wash ke liye jate gaadi, so titla mechanic nahi mhanto ramp var gaadi gya. Ramp var manje kay, a slope that I have, and I take the vehicle at some elevation, and from beneath also I can wash the car, I can make the repairs. So that is a ramp. Ramp means continuously varying signal. Now here, ramp type of ADC, instead of DAC, what I have is, I have a ramp signal generator. Now ramp signal generator is continuously variable signal with respect to time that I am generating. So remaining part is same. So earlier in the successive approximation method, I was generating a known signal in step fashion, 7.5 volt once, 7.6 volt once, 7.7 volts once, till it reached 8 volt. As an example, 8 volt is my analog signal. So stepwise I was increasing the signal. Here, the clock will be generating the signal, and the gate will remain opened for these ports. For this port, for op-amp port, it will be closed initially. So the clock will generate the continuously variable signal, so that it will be given to your ramp generator. Here also, the digital pulse train will be converted to analog voltage in a ramped fashion, in a continuously increasing fashion. So that ramp voltage is given to my operational amplifier, which is a comparator here. Okay, so comparator continuously, earlier in the successive approximation, as and when the signal is there, it used to compare. As and when I received a step signal, it used to compare. Now, in ramp ADC, my comparator will be comparing the ramp signal continuously. Till what point? Till the ramp generated signal becomes equal to my analog signal. So the job of the comparator, or the op-amp as a comparator, is same. It keeps on comparing this generated voltage by my RAM generator to the unknown analog input signal. So as and when this generated signal becomes equal to my analog signal, this gate, this port remains closed. Once it becomes equal to or greater than the analog signal, once the generated signal, ramp generated signal becomes equal to or more than my unknown analog signal, then this port will be opened. And in that case, this clock port will be closed. This port will also be closed. So then at that time, when this unknown analog signal becomes equal to my generated signal, at that time, this port will be opened and the counter will show a digital number. That will be the number corresponding to my analog input signal. This is what is the principle of ramp ADC. The chances are that you may not understand so many things, but you have to keep on reading, and some basics we should know. Gate is sort of a switch. It allows the ports to open as and when required. We have got different types of gates. If we need, we'll just brush up in the digital signal class. We'll this brush up these gate concept, clock concept we already discussed. More than that, yesterday only, for your information, yesterday only I have uploaded the Boulton PDF copy. Okay, it is in unit 1 notes part. In our Google Classroom, you'll find the book by the book on mechatronics by W. Boulton. Okay, which is our textbook, and from that book only I have taken all these points and I have prepared my PPT. Okay, so keep that in mind and enroll yourself for our Google Classroom, and if required, you can download that soft copy of the book and start studying. So this ramp ADC is used as an A to D converter. Hello, so class nadu amel maatradre. So the next we'll see the theoretical part that is mentioned here. The ramp, please be attentive. The ramp form of ADC involves an analog voltage which is increased at a constant rate, a so-called ramp voltage. So ramp voltage, if I plot it on my XY axis, X axis the time axis and Y axis the signal axis, maybe voltage axis. So I'll get a straight line maybe at 45 degrees. That is the ramp signal. What does it mean? Voltage is increasing continuously, proportionately with respect to time. So that's a ramp signal, a so-called ramp voltage, and applied to a comparator where it is compared with the analog voltage from the sensor. The time taken for the ramp voltage to increase to the value of the sensor voltage will depend on the size of the sampled analog voltage. Yes. So the iterations those are required for reaching out the unknown analog voltage will be, okay, that can also be set. Okay. When the ramp voltage starts, a gate is opened which starts a binary counter counting the regular pulses from a clock. When the two voltages are equal, the gate closes and the word indicated by the counter is the digital representation of the sampled analog voltage. So this is what is the concept behind ramp ADC. The next one is, rather this is the simple one and most frequently used, A to D converter, flash type of A to D converter, or direct type of A to D converter. Please be attentive. Okay, so what you can see, if you just see the diagram, instead of one comparator, one op-amp, I got number of op-amps. So just focus on this figure. I got number of op-amps and I have a encoder logic circuit here, and that from that encoder logic circuit, digital output is taken out. Now three lines are drawn there. That means it will be a 3-bit digital output that will be coming. Okay, so this is what is the indicator of these lines. Then from each of the op-amps, I have got one output, one output, one output, one output. Please be attentive. And for each operational amplifier, I have got minus means inverting port, plus means non-inverting port. So each op-amp has got one inverting port and one non-inverting. Minus corresponds to inverting port, plus corresponds to non-inverting ports. Like that, I have got non-inverting port and inverting port. What you can see here, the analog signal that I want to convert into digital form is just connected here, just here. It is connected to inverting port. Okay, inverting port of each of the op-amp. Please be attentive. So the analog signal which is to be converted into digital form is connected to inverting port. And all the non-inverting ports, all the non-inverting ports of the op-amp, operational amplifier, are connected together to a, this is called as a resistance ladder. This is called as a resistance ladder. Each one is connected to, this first one connected to a common reference voltage. This is called as the reference voltage branch. So to the non-inverting port of the op-amp, I am providing some reference voltage. I can decide how much voltage I want to give. I can give 5 volt, I can give 10 volts, I can give 15 volt, 12 volt, whatever it is. Okay, so this resistance ladder, just be focused on this. Now in this, each is this resistance ladder. What I can see, I am starting from least significant bit. Okay, so what is that least significant bit? If I have got a binary number denoted as 1100, which is the LSB, least significant bit in 1100, the rightmost bit, the first zero on the right hand side is the least significant bit. And the highest bit, leftmost bit, 1100, the first leftmost one is my most significant bit. Okay, so that 1100, what number it corresponds to? Starting from right, 2 to the power 0. 0 means I don't have that number. 2 to the power 1. 0 means I have got the number 1100. Note down somewhere, 1100. We are starting from rightmost digit now. The first rightmost digit is 0. What does it mean? It corresponds to 2 to the power 0 number. When it means 0, so that number 2 to the power 0 is 1, but that 1 is not there because 0 is there. So next is 2 to the power 1. That corresponds to the second 0 from right. So that number is also not there. This 2 to the power 1 corresponds to 2. The next digit, the third digit from right, 1100. Okay, so third one corresponds to, yes, this is a valid number. So it is 2 to the power 2. 2 to the power 2, yes, means 4. Plus, come to the leftmost number. First one corresponds to 2 to the power 3. So that is 8. 1 means yes. So 8 plus 4 is 12. So 12, if the decimal number is 12, digital equivalent is 1100. Okay. So the least significant bit, rightmost bit is 0. The leftmost bit is 1. So in this case, it is MSB. Rightmost is LSB and leftmost is MSB. So in this circuit, the first operational amplifier corresponds to least significant bit, LSB. And the topmost operational amplifier corresponds to most significant bit. So please be attentive, friends. Okay. So this is a resistance ladder. What I have done, the non-inverting ports are connected to the resistance ladder. Non-inverting ports of each of the op-amps are connected to this resistance ladder. Okay, so the first step in the ladder corresponds to 1k ohm resistance and it corresponds to 1 volt DC. Because I am giving some supply, depending on the resistance value, I'll be getting the impressed voltage, isn't it? So V is equal to IR, right? So whatever is the resistance value corresponding to that, I'll be giving that much voltage to this op-amp. So this branch, or the first step of this resistance ladder, corresponds to 1 volt. Second step corresponds to 2 volt. Third step corresponds to 3 volt. Fourth step corresponds to 4, 5, 6, 7. So 7 resistances I have. Then I have got 3k ohm or 3 kilo ohm resistance, and then I have got one more step. Eighth step corresponding to 10 volt DC. This is called as the resistance ladder. Remember, our objective is to convert the analog signal into equivalent digital signal. Okay. Now let us take the case. Now, my analog input, let us say it is corresponding to 2.5 volt DC. Okay. Just to understand, 2.5 volt DC. So what will happen? This signal is given here. It will be compared. 2.5 volt will be compared. This op amp is acting as a comparator. It will be compared at this step. How much is the voltage? At this step, the voltage is 1. Okay. So 2.5 volt is greater than 1 volt. 2.5 volt is greater than 1 volt. So it will generate? Yes, 1. Yes, it is more than. If the signal is more than 1 volt, it will say 1. Okay, digital 1. So 1 will be coded here in the encoder logic. Then, second step, 2 volt. 2.5 volt is greater than 2 volts, isn't it? So this op amp also compare. My unknown voltage is 2.5 volt. And presently, I am giving the input voltage as 2 volts. So 2.5 volt is greater than 2 volt. So yes, so this will also generate bit 1. Okay, so next step. This is my 2.5 volt. Here I am generating 3 volt. So what does it mean? 2.5 volt is less than 3 volt. So it will generate 0. Likewise, so beyond 3 volt, it will generate 0, 0, 0. Up to 2 volt, it will be generating 1 and 1. So 1, 1, these will be generated. Now in the encoder logic circuit, what we have? We have the Boolean logic operators here, which will generate a 3-digit or 3-bit number using this logic. As I have converted 1, 1, 0, 0, 0 is the number that I have corresponding to my 2.5 volt, isn't it? So that will be modified to provide me equivalent digital output. Okay, so let us repeat this discussion in the next class as G.R. Deshpande is appearing on the screen. We'll stop for today. This flash.